Hi, this is Dr. Nemechek. This is another one of our video blogs, and I would like to discuss about heartburn. Very, very common, I think really becoming almost epidemic in the population, and it's often viewed as a problem that people make too much stomach acid. Well, actually, it looks like when you analyze the amount of acid that a person with heartburn makes in 24 hours, it's about the same as a person who doesn't have heartburn. So really, in fact, the symptoms of heartburn, which are relieved with an antacid, are actually not because you make too much acid. It's because you can't empty the acid you make. Now, I use an analogy that this is similar to why you call the plumber when the kitchen sink's overflowing. You know, you talk to him on the phone. He says he'll be there in an hour. And he says, turn the water off. Just don't run the water. And that helps a little bit. That's like taking a little Prilosec. But it's really not the problem. The problem isn't that the faucet puts too much water in the sink. The problem is the sink doesn't empty. And that's the same thing with heartburn. It's not that you make too much acid. It's that your nervous system cannot empty the acid you're making in your stomach. And then further, as that gets magnified, the little valve between the stomach and the esophagus, which is controlled by your nervous system, doesn't work as well. And through the normal kind of grinding motion of the stomach, dang stuff squirts backwards up the esophagus. Now you have heartburn and what's called GERD, or gastroesophageal reflux disease, okay? And both of these get better with, or I should say, feel better with an antacid, but the problem is mainly with your autonomic nervous system. Again, the autonomic nervous system, you can think of it kind of like the automatic nervous system. It controls everything that you can't really consciously influence. And so blood pressure, your organ function, a large part of your immune system, many of your hormones, and in this case, your intestinal tract and your stomach. Now, I like to think of the intestinal tract as an intestinal conveyor belt that kind of pushes everything along. And it has its own little symptoms for each little segment when it doesn't work right. And the typical problem with intestinal motility, now your autonomics, you've got the sympathetic and parasympathetic branches. They should be fairly equal. And what happens is you have an imbalance. You have a relatively high amount of sympathetic input versus a lower parasympathetic input. The typical problem here is that the parasympathetics are weakened. That's really kind of where the problem comes from, to give you that. And when you have this imbalance, the intestinal conveyor belt doesn't work right. So what happens? Well, some people, it starts up here in the throat. They get this tightness, like the collar is too tight or something, like they're choking, but they don't actually choke when they swallow or drink. But it feels like they might. That's called globus. Then you can have trouble actually with motility, a passage of stuff through the esophagus, and people get sticking or cramping there. The stomach portion, as we're talking about, you won't empty acid correctly. The stomach just doesn't work right. Sometimes you won't empty food correctly, and it's so bad, and people might vomit up undigested food hours later. Okay, and that in its most severe form is called gastroparesis. If you have slow motility through the entire small intestine, that gives you the cramping of IBS, could give you bloating, gas, and then poor forward motility in the colon is constipation. Yep, constipation is a brain problem, believe it or not. Okay, so now, heartburn. How can we deal with this? Well, there's a variety of things that feed into this problem that can cause the symptoms. And a main thing is it's divided into two main problems. One is the bacteria themselves in the intestinal tract can communicate with the brain and trigger heartburn. And then injury, kind of chronic injury dysfunction to the brain itself. So now let's talk about the bacteria. There's a condition called bacterial overgrowth, where the bacteria in the colon are now living up in the small intestine. These are normally very different groups of bacteria. In my books, I talk about the bacteria in the small intestine are birds, the ones in the colon are fish. And for every one bird by the stomach, you have 100 million fish at the end of the colon. So you have very different bacteria, huge differential. And what happens, and this is a term I don't like called SIBO, small intestinal bacterial overgrowth, is where basically the fish bacteria are living up with the birds. And now you have about 100,000 times the bacteria up there. And so this is the sequence where somebody says, some particular food, so maybe tomatoes or spices or lettuce or bananas or orange juice or chocolate or coffee. It can be almost anything, but this like one food gives me heartburn. And that is a very clear picture that you have bacterial overgrowth. And when you fix that condition, so in kids you would use inulin fiber and in adults we use the antibiotic rifaximin, when you fix that problem, within a week or two, people can suddenly have tomatoes and spices, all right? And they don't get heartburn. They don't have that digestive problem. Now, so the bacteria can be part of this. But I'll have many patients where that will happen. They can now eat tomatoes and spices, but they still have heartburn left over. So, like, part of it went away, but not the whole thing. And what they have is they have both problems. All right, so the autonomics and this relative imbalance of sympathetic and parasympathetics, okay, it's a brain problem, okay? And this is where kind of the magic of the Nemechek Protocol has been helpful in getting your brain to restore functionality to get that to empty. And so the Nemechek Protocol basically is a reduction of inflammation in the brain, well, through the whole body, but we're targeting the brain and the nervous system. And when we reduce that enough, the nervous system is able to repair itself and regain functionality. And voila, a lot of people, their heartburn goes away. And so the components of the Nemechek Protocol are basically a really high concentration DHA fish oil, olive oil, which blocks toxicity from vegetable oils, fixing the gut bacteria, and then for older folks, say over, you know, 40, 45, we generally need a vagus nerve stimulator to get the brain to fully function right. And when you add those things together, all sorts of symptoms go away, including heartburn, IBS, cramping, and even your constipation. Okay? So that's all for today. This is Dr. Nemechek. Thank you for listening. I hope that you found this video useful.